I'm an engineer. I love digging stuff. I love building things. So what we've been doing these past couple days, we obviously have dozers, graders out here, and we've been digging holes mainly. And what we're digging is hull deflate, turret deflate, which are fine position for survivability for the Strikers.
The Striker, or the 8-wheeled armored fighting vehicle, is used for its diverse mobile and tactical capabilities. The engineers come into play by providing a unit cover and concealment through artificial entrenchments.
We actually had the dig rates and all the depths for all the fighting positions for the tanks and everything. Now we had to change it up and use it for the Strikers. For a defensive aspect of the fight, these fighting positions for the Strikers are extremely crucial for us to get, I'd say, get the upper hand on the enemy.
Deflates are dug into the ground to provide cover for vehicles in an open area like this one. You can virtually watch this 18-ton vehicle and its fighting crew disappear out of sight and out of mind to any enemy force. They also practice rapid bridge deployment, enabling the vehicle to pass over what would otherwise bring them to a halt, like a river or ravine. These engineers are making our fighting force just a little bit stronger.
It's spectacular. These soldiers have worked really hard since the brigade set up. We support the maneuver battalions, and the work that we do increases survivability for those maneuver formations across the brigade.
Reporting from Fort Carson, Colorado, I'm Army Sergeant Megan Berry.